For how long will you continue like this?
I think I've tolerated your excesses enough. I'll be left with no choice than to say thank you for your services when no longer needs it.
Sir, I'm very sorry, sir. You know it's quite difficult coping my baby's needs every morning, sir. And moreover, this is what I owe to my own son, sir.
In that case, I will have you tender your resignation letter right away.
Sir, I don't think that is necessary. All she needs is Disney.
Disney?
Yes. Morning, sir.
Kay.
Sir.
So early today.
Yes, sir. Indeed, Disney is the answer.
Thanks to Disney.
Your family answer.
Visit us today at Destiny Baby Cradle Crèche and Daycare, number 62A Jetu Road, Auchi, behind UBA Bank, or call us at 070-346-2648. Destiny Baby Cradle and Crèche. Truly, your child is in safe hands.
Hello viewers, you're on to another interesting segment of Time Out with Amidat, and as always, I'm your host, Amidat Lega. Well, today we have a very special person, a special guest in the house today. She's an intelligent, young, hardworking woman, and she's no other person than Queen Blessing Ebigeson. You're welcome to the program.
Thank you very much.
So, Queen, I want you to tell us a bit about yourself, your childhood, how has it been so far?
Okay, you already know my name. My name is Queen Blessing Ebigeson. I was born in Benue State.
Okay.
I grew up partly in the north, Niger State.
Okay.
I'm from Edo State, from Imiakana to be precise, in Okpela.
Okay.
My nursery and primary school was in Benue State. I went to Tilega, the nursery and primary school. My secondary school was Federal Government Girls College in Bida, okay. Niger State. And okay. Also my high institution was in Federal Polytechnic Bida, where I read mass communication.
Okay.
And I've been an actress for 12 years. And then if you want to know about my challenges, I don't know, I've had a lot of ups and downs.
Okay.
I used to sell pepper, onions, and all those things to pay my way through school.
Okay.
I also ran a restaurant at some point to make sure that I get to where I am today, because I've always seen myself like somebody who is going to be the Oprah Winfrey of Nigeria.
Okay.
So that's about my background.
Well, we all have dreams and aspirations, and shortly we'll be giving you a short clip of Blessings and TV program. It's called
YTT Show.
So don't go away and enjoy watching. We'll be back shortly.
To some, life is not a bed of roses. Why to some, life is filled with great opportunities. Every opportunity has its own challenges. How we deal with our challenges in life guarantees our tomorrow. I explained what this program is all about to you, and you were interested because a lot of people know Akin Lewis, you know, the famous Akin Lewis, the superstar, the man who has worked with so many, you know, companies and all of that, but they don't know, you know, how you started your life and everything. And I think they want to know that. They want to know who is Akin Lewis, how did he start?
Well, thank you very much. It's indeed of interest to me that youth realize that they can make it
Well, the program is YTT, yesterday, today and tomorrow. So, Blessing, please, what is YTT about?
YTT, what I do on YTT show, I bring up prominent people to tell us about, to celebrate their today, which is the first day. Yeah. And then to tell us about their yesterday, which is the why.
Okay.
And then tell us where they believe their tomorrow will be like, you know, what they believe their tomorrow will be like, being the fact that they've put on so much work in their life.
Yeah.
So that's why it's called YTT Show, Yesterday, Today, and Tomorrow.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. I also want to a TV section, as in acting and also producing and has all these old things. Where did you get this old inspiration to go into TV acting, production and all?
I'm a fighter, like I always tell people. I'm one woman that believes that the sky is my limit through hard work.
Yeah.
And I'm one person that believes if this way is not working, you should try another one.
Yeah.
I'm one person that also believes because Nigeria is a very expensive country, I must do more than one thing to survive.
Exactly. Yeah.
I don't believe I should rely on any man to do the things that I need for me. I love money. I love the good things of life. And for me to be able to get those things that I want, I believe I should do a lot of things.
Yeah.
So as when I started acting 12 years ago, the roles were not really coming because I was a new person.
Yeah.
And the discrimination in Nollywood is kind of on the high side when you're not from the Igbo-speaking parts of Nigeria. So I was able to conquer them because I was not just acting. If I don't get an acting job today, I'll get a modeling job.
Yeah.
If I don't get a modeling job today, I'll get a dancing. At some point, I used to dance.
Yeah.
You know, because I did videos for Tony Tetuila, Idris Abu Karim, Fatuma Wanda, etc.
Yeah.
You know, so you can never frustrate me because if I'm not working for you today, I'm working for the next person. So there's no week I don't work. So because of this, I always, you know, pressure myself in doing things. Even if I don't know it, I will tell you I know it because I believe I will learn on the job.
Okay.
I think producing for me started 3 years ago.
Okay.
You know, when English industry started frustrating me badly, I decided that, okay, I speak a little bit of Yoruba.
Yeah.
Why can't I just do something?
Okay.
And if you want to produce an English, it's more expensive because, like I said, they discriminate a lot.
Yeah.
And you cannot, you know, use probably like 5 million to choose a good, you know, English movie. But with like 3 million naira, you're able to choose a very good Yoruba movie. And you find out that people will work with you with one heart, especially if you can speak their language and you respect them.
Yes.
They will just fall in love with you. If you see me on location, you will not know I'm not Yoruba. They just love me like I'm their own.
Okay.
You know, so that was how I started using. The first movie I produced was a Yoruba movie. It's Borokini. It's already out in the market. I used Jide Kosoko, Nike Diba, Antitoni Adewale, and Kadabo, and a lot of them. Shegu Arinze was also in that movie as well. And then after that movie, I did some work, Super Smiley Anuga. I also did El Dorado. It's a soap opera, which I did. I played the lead character, which I did about 94 episodes.
Oh, wow.
It was a soap that I did for a whole year.
Yeah.
You know, that will run for a whole year. You know, as I work for people, I also try to do my own thing.
Yes.
You know, I also went into location again. I did Loriere, which I just launched 28th of October 2012. That was when I did the launching. And that was when I also launched my foundation, which is my pet project at the moment.
Okay.
And I also try to write stories because I believe that I don't believe in fiction. I believe we have a lot of things around us that we should put to work so that people can learn from. I don't believe we should just sit down and cook up one thing when we have a lot of raw materials lying down. You know, that was why I decided that, okay, let me be writing small. I'm not very perfect at it, but I'm trying.
Well, now, listen, we're going to talk about your latest production, which is
Loriere on the Run. Loriere means on the run.
Okay, so we'll show the viewers now. I have a very short clip of your movie now. I want the viewers to see what you have in store and how intelligently this lady has worked to produce this marvelous and beautiful clip. So do enjoy it. We'll be back shortly.
She be one of only 20,000. But don't come in on the wa. Come share me, no. Come share me. Pina, I love you so much. You want to go to
Japan? Tu vas, Bisi. Emi lo nku o. Oh, ba to free pe mo ti dagba. O so explain what? To na explain. Lo ba yo koso lori phone si. Ni lo e temi. O pe n debi. I miss your kisses. I love you. O wa to mi donku.
From the first time to move for Jumi Reba and Mochi like it. So I Mumbe Mofia could your girlfriend me. Mo force a leo. Mokofia could fool me any chance, make where I can prove her, Miss Ye. It be more like it.
Well, I mean, not like ye. Who can check a room by me? You know, a lot of guys have come into my life and they tell me a series of stories, you know, and at the end of the day, they just break my heart.
Welcome back, viewers. If you're just joining me, this is Time Out with Amidat, and today we have a very special guest, a very, very intelligent young lady. She's no other person than Queen Blessing. Welcome, Blessing. I've actually had a wonderful time with you, and now we're going to the next segment, which is your foundation. I've heard so much about your foundation, how well they've been trying to help widows now, and presently you decided to bring your foundation down to Edo State, you know, your original place. Yeah. Now, why did you decide to do this? Because judging from the fact that you had a lot of sponsors out there when you had just done this whole thing in Lagos, why did you choose to come to Edo State?
Well, number one, I chose to come to Edo State because I'm from here.
Okay.
And no matter how bad you look at it, we cannot run away from home.
Exactly.
The reason why we run away from home sometimes is because we believe that there are witches. You know, when you come to your hometown, they will just think you're too comfortable. They will think that you have so much, you know, and then they will know that you're also hustling, that it's not easy out there. It's so expensive. I mean, here, you don't have to rent a house. You can stay in your father's house. I mean, there, you have to pay house rent. You pay, you know, all this
stuff.
But
bills.
They don't see it that way. So most of the time, we want to come back, but we're afraid. But this time around, I said to myself, my son is 5 years old. I've been able to do things for the Igbos, the Hausas, the Yorubas, and all that. Why won't I come and do something for my own people? And I thought about it. I did a prayer and I told God that I'm coming here to do something for my own people. And I believe that as I came here in One Health, I will go back in One Health. I don't want, you know, fear. It is when you have fear in your mind that evil things happen to you.
Yeah.
I decided to eliminate that fear completely from my mind. But the challenges that I've had is because the last time I came here was 10 years ago.
Okay.
And I was really small.
Okay.
I didn't know people that I know now. And the foundation has patrons.
Okay.
But there are no one is from Edo State.
Okay.
So normally when I pick a project like this, they support that project. Before it's the time, they would buy all the gifts that I need to give to people.
Yeah.
But this time around, it was so difficult because they are not from here. And they were like thinking, what's their benefit?
Wow.
You know Nigerians, most of them, 95% of Nigerians will not do something for you without thinking of the gain.
To get out of it.
You understand?
Yes,
so I think... I don't know. I want to believe that they just felt they cannot come to the event and talk about, as most of them are politicians, and talk about politics or whatever. So they just felt, what will I gain? So they just ignored the whole project. I'm one stubborn woman. If you know me very well, I'm so stubborn that when I set my mind doing something, you can't frustrate me. I told myself, okay, if I don't get people to do this thing the way I want it to be done, as I want it, I can still do something small, and I'll still achieve my goal.
Well, viewers, before we go on to the go of the personal segment, I want you to ask one question for me now. But last but least, I want to remember, because I have some years now in the shackles and all. But for you, Queen, I'm the one who's going to remain in the sand of time. Should I say sand or rocks or because I
want that one is good.
Well, I would want to be remembered.
I would love to be remembered. If you notice, everything about me is Queen. My foundation is Queen Foundation for the Village. My production outfit, Beauty Productions. And if you notice all the works that I do, including my movies, I pass messages. And one message I keep passing in different ways is that we shouldn't take into crime.
Okay.
You know, we shouldn't go into drug peddling. We shouldn't do anything that is illegal. I'd like people to remember me for one person who decided on her own to fight all this thing they call corruption, even though she believes that. It might not go too far, maybe because I'm just one person trying to do this, but I believe that I must be heard.
Yeah.
So I like people to remember me for who I am,
okay.
Somebody who believes that straightforwardness is the key.
Okay. Well, 12 years, it has been a wonderful time with you, Queen. I actually enjoyed this interview section with you. It's been very, very, very inspiring. Since I met you, you've been a whole lot, you know, a full package for me. And I've actually drawn from your strengths. And although I know there are weaknesses, though, we're not going to talk about them now, because I see your strength as something that surmounts every other weaknesses. So I don't think there's anything like weakness. It always makes you, it just prepares you for greater things and greater heights. I want to wish you good luck on your foundation.
Thank you.
And I won't say the sky is your limit now. I think the sky is your starting point for me now. So I wish you best of luck. And our viewers, it has been a full time with Queen. And secondly, Queen has decided to choose February 14th, the day we all know as St. Valentine's Day, day to show love. For me, I don't think that's a particular day to show love, because I show love every day of my life. So, but that particular day has been scheduled for Lover's Day. But Queen decided not to spend love with with love as in the love segment, but she has decided to show her love to the widows of Opela Kingdom. It's going to be a wonderful section. She has been telling about the foundation, so they are going to have a very huge party with the widows in Opela. So if you're a widow, or you just, if you are from Opela, it's best for you to go to that particular venue. How would it be then?
It's going to be at Imiakana Town Hall in Imiegere here.
Okay.
You know, you won't miss your way. If you get to Okugbe, just say you're going to Imiegere.
Okay.
Probably just say you are going to Okashe.
Okay.
And as soon as you get here, just ask anybody, where are they having the Valentine party?
Okay.
And I'm sure that, you know, they will lead you through.
Okay. Well, you heard it all from Queen, and this is where we call the shots for the personality segment. We'll move on to the next event on the program, and it's tea time out, Zambi. That's don't go away. There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. It's brighter than tomorrow. If you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. It's place, feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get there. If you care enough for the living, make a little space. Make a better place.
Thank you very much. We want to thank the
Keep quiet, please.
God, the Almighty God, for counting us among the living. I want you all to know that on behalf of the youngest old man and the host of friends, we really appreciate you all. I want you to keep on doing what you are doing. Know that God is your Father, and will continue to provide for us.
If my heart is full of joy, Mrs. Vero just said, a native of Akana Uzaro, it's our well local government area. I appreciate this old man and his friends that pay us visit this afternoon. The phones, clothes, food items, we appreciate them. That God Almighty will reward them abundantly. For that also, in the life of the children, God will present their life, their children, their everything about them. They will live for 50 days on earth. Because God does think that for his land, God will by itself repay them back. So we are very happy.
I just wanted to skip on the Let's Pray page. This way I spend my Valentine. I believe I live here. When we are saying February for the Lover's Day, I don't have love, so the children are my love. So for me, I'll go to another one to spend my time. I don't want the public to show love to this kid. I believe tomorrow the president there, the governor here, to support them by the grace of God, and we'll have to support the rest of them.
Thank you, but
I have a lot to say about this visit. First of all, I want to reach out to everybody watching this program right now, because this orphanage has been a personal project for me, because these kids are more or less like mine, and for all that's out there who go, you will find I go through the pains of childbirth and all of a sudden you have to do just to abandon your child and all. So I want to reach out to them, try as much as possible, whatever you have. It's not until when you're rich that you give up the poor, give out to the needy. Even if it's just a few cups of rice, you prepare, you come on every day or some days or so, you just prepare and come and share with the children. You take everything out of you.
The truth is that you never know what God does for you until you see people who have different circumstances, different from you. I mean, you could be in Abuja, in Lagos, wherever you are, and the problem is, yeah, your house rent, 2 million to 1.5 million, but there are people who just need the basic things of life. And as much as possible, it behoves on us to, in a way, we can contribute to the welfare of the less privileged as much as possible. Because the truth is that living, in our own opinion, is actually giving, And as much as possible, like the other person said, use the opportunity, every opportunity you have, to be part of somebody else's life and make somebody else happy.
Thank you for inviting me. Had lots of fun and
5 years. Now I'll be showing the sports segment on Time Out with Amidat. We usually have an ongoing sports competition that has been sponsored by Honorable Abdulrazak of the Dustin House of Assembly, and it's also known as Tabla. Now the sports competition will be shown shortly. I'll be showing you the number of goals scored so far and what has been happening generally. Just stay tuned and enjoy watching. Particularly the youth out there, please, whatever you do, whatever worth doing is worth doing well. So if you want to go into music, if you want to go into comedy shows, if you want to go into dance, please do endeavor to call us. We're showing your numbers on the screen. Please call us on these numbers to tell us what you want to do, because as time goes on, we hope to have live concerts on Time Out. I mean, that we have youths come out to perform and show their talents on the program. So if you're interested in this particular job or this particular segment, please reach us on the number showing on your screen. Or you can call us on, or meet us or reach us on our Facebook page at Time Out. I mean, that's facebook.com is our fan page. All you need to do is just like the page and actually post your comments. We get to read them and also get back to you. Then on the comedy segment, please, we need live comedians on the stage too. So if you're interested and you want to come on live on studio with me on my program, all you need to do is call us on the numbers and we'll gladly oblige you the opportunity of showing your beautiful self on this program. Well, to hear from you again next week. That's why for now, do have a lovely day and a blessed week ahead.